Hey guys, Lucas here, and welcome back to our channel. And as you know, we like to share with you all that there is to know about internet security. And in today's video, we're gonna be talking about hiding your location, or more specifically, your internet protocol address when you're on the internet. Now, internet protocol addresses are more commonly known as IP addresses, and that's how your location is identified when you send or receive information, which includes everything from emails to browsing the web. And there are many reasons why you may want to or even should hide your IP address, and there are different ways to do that too, which I'll be talking about as well. And as always, we'll include any helpful links in the description area below, so be sure to check out those as well if you'd like. So first, if you're wondering why someone might want to hide their IP address, the most common reason is for privacy, security, and anonymity. Now, most of us like cookies. I mean, I know I do, but hiding your IP avoids tracking cookies, which many companies use to track your browsing, and that can even be based on your actual location. And being concerned about having your real location being tracked doesn't necessarily mean you have to be Jason Bourne or 007. Or even that you're a celebrity. In today's world, online anonymity reasons can be as simple as owning a business or working from home. And other reasons might include journalists protecting their sources, but really anyone sending or receiving sensitive information would want to make online security a priority. Now, getting into all the reasons of why someone would want to hide their IP address online is a whole other video, but other reasons include accessing geo-blocked information, downloading information securely, and getting around an IP ban. So those are just some of the reasons why people hide their IP addresses online. However, when it comes to privacy and security, it makes it harder for cyber criminals to attack your devices when you hide your IP. And it makes it so that your online activities aren't being monitored by whoever might be trying to monitor you with tracking cookies. So that being said, the quickest and most efficient way to hide your IP address is by using a VPN. And it's also the safest if you use a top quality VPN. Now, if you've seen any of our other videos that we've done, you already know that we often recommend staying away from most free VPNs for a couple of reasons. First, they often come with tracking cookies and malware of their own. And second, they often sell your information to third parties, all of which you're trying to avoid in the first place. So I would say if you decide to go with a free VPN, just make sure you're reading the privacy policy very carefully before you accept it, to make sure they're not sneaking something in there that's going to be more trouble than it's worth. But that being said, paid VPNs really aren't that costly, honestly, usually just a few dollars a month, and they're much more effective. So we'll put a couple of our recommendations in the description area below if you'd like to check those out. Now, VPNs work by connecting you to a proxy server, which shields or hides your IP address, and basically makes your IP appear as your VPN's IP. Alternatively, but less securely overall, you can connect to another proxy server, which is a service you can get for free or pay for, and connect to their servers in order to hide your location as well. The difference between using a proxy server and using a VPN is that a VPN also encrypts your data, making it unreadable, even if someone were to intercept your data in transit. So a VPN protects your data end to end, from your end to theirs, while the proxy alone doesn't have this protection. A proxy server does have protection on their end while you're connected. However, a VPN protects you the entire time, and it also protects more than just browsing, unlike a proxy. And there are a ton of great VPNs out there for you to choose from, so you can absolutely find one that's best for you. But if that process sounds a bit overwhelming and you just want some direction, I do have a video on my top recommendations for cybersecurity products, and I include my top VPN pick on that video as well. So I'll leave a link to that in the description area, and feel free to check that out if you're looking for an idea of which VPN might be best for you. And now moving on from VPNs, a third way to hide your IP address is by using Tor, which was originally called the Onion Router. Now, Tor is basically a tool that provides anonymity by using a series of computers which are distributed across the world to hide your IP addresses and make your network trail difficult to trace. This, however, can make your connection very slow, but it's completely free and trustworthy, and it adds layers of encryption by making internet traffic leave your device and take a random route. There are some advantages to using Tor, like the fact that it's free, and many users of Tor also use it combined with a VPN as well, because it only secures your browsing, so that's something to keep in mind if you decide to use Tor. Now, another option to hide your IP address is using public Wi-Fi, like at your local library or coffee shop, but as we've mentioned before, this also raises your risk for cyber attacks. So you probably wouldn't want to use the local Wi-Fi unless you are also using a VPN, and your VPN is going to hide your IP address already anyways. So just know that using public networks is an option to hide your IP in a pinch, even if you choose to not use a VPN, but it does come with some risk. So just be aware of that. All right, guys, so that's four ways you can hide your IP address, and we hope you found this video helpful. If so, please leave a thumbs up as it always makes my day. And if you have any questions about cybersecurity or VPNs, we're always happy to help with those. Also, if there are any other video topics that you think we should address, please let us know down in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you about that. Otherwise, guys, thanks so much for watching. Welcome to the community. Thanks for being one of our cyber friends, and I will look forward to seeing you in the next video.